Welcome, everyone. My name is Andrea Brandsness. I'm with the New Jersey Department of Human Services in the Division on Aging. And we're here today to talk to you about the Chronic Disease Self-Management Program, which is a program that we have available through our division. It's available statewide. And in New Jersey, it's called Take Control of Your Health. We're going to learn about this and one other evidence-based program today, which is called Better Choices, Better Health, which is the online version of this program. And they are both licensed and developed by Stanford University. Now, these programs are offered to adults that are 18 years of age and older that have chronic conditions, or if the individual is a caregiver of someone with a chronic condition, they're also appropriate for this program. So any adult, including Medicaid managed care members, can participate in the community-based program. But only Medicaid managed care members can participate in the online program. So our goals for today are to help you learn a little bit more about the Chronic Disease Self-Management Program and the online version of this same program so that you can better refer members to take advantage of this evidence-based program. These are our goals. We want you to know how the program works. We want you to be able to differentiate between the community-based and online. Know which members might benefit from participating and are appropriate to refer, and then how to make a referral for members to either the community-based or online program. I want to start by giving you a little bit of background about the Chronic Disease Self-Management Program. It was developed in the early 1990s by Stanford University at their Center for Research in Patient Education. It is designed to give participants both the knowledge and skills to take a more active role in the day-to-day management of their ongoing health conditions. It is considered the gold standard of evidence-based disease prevention programs because research has proven its success in a variety of settings. There is a lot of information about the research that's been done to validate this program that you can find on Stanford's website. And the link to Stanford's website is in your handout. The program is not only available in New Jersey, it's available around the country, and it's also available internationally. So it's currently used in 17 countries and many states throughout the United States. The online version of this program was introduced in the late 2000s. So why would we offer a program like this? Well, we all know that many adults, particularly older adults, have not only one, but two and three chronic health conditions that can't be cured, that once they're diagnosed, they really have to, on a day-to-day basis, manage and try to improve their quality of life through better management and self-management of their condition. Additional facts about why we would want to offer the program, again, 68% of individuals have one or more chronic conditions. 32% are living with frequent or constant pain. It's something we hear a lot from individuals. Many people are confused by what to do when they leave their provider's office. These statistics are from a survey that was done by the National Council on Aging of Americans over age 44. And 45% don't receive referrals to resources such as counseling. So this program is a nice complement to what the medical community is providing to individuals with chronic health conditions. The philosophy of the program is really that people with long-term health conditions have some very similar issues. They, no matter what their condition, deal with the impact on their lives and their emotions. It may affect their family life, performance at work, ability to enjoy social or leisure activities. So it brings together people with a variety of chronic health conditions because they're focusing really not on the disease, but on better management of the symptoms so that they can improve their quality of life. The other aspect or part of Stanford's philosophy with this program is that it was really designed to be led by individuals that come from the community. Individuals with chronic health conditions can actually teach this workshop by using a scripted manual, and they are often as effective, if not more effective, than healthcare professionals because they are truly serving as models for the folks that attend the workshops. So this is how the program works. It is a 6-week workshop. Each workshop is 2.5 hours. The participants in the group sit in a circle or a U-shape, so the room is not set up classroom style, and that's done to encourage discussion and interaction throughout the session. The groups are small, they're usually between 10 and 16 people, and this is a requirement that Stanford has in their guidelines for the program. If the group is too large, there is not enough opportunity for everyone to share, and if the group is too small, the full group dynamic doesn't develop. It is led always by a pair of peer leaders, and again, we mentioned that very often the peer leaders are folks that have a chronic health condition themselves, or it may be a healthcare professional, but when we have healthcare professionals leading the workshop, we ask them to really be in the role of a peer to the individuals that are attending the session. The locations are offered locally in the community, such as senior centers, community centers, churches, libraries, or any other handicapped accessible location. Now, the online version of the program, obviously, that is for somebody to log into a computer wherever they have access to that computer, so it's really at their convenience in their own home or, again, wherever they might access the computer. There are a lot of opportunities for discussion and problem solving throughout the course of the workshop. The curriculum is very interactive. It is not a sit and listen type of session. The folks are engaged in approximately 46 activities throughout the course of the 6 weeks, so that they really do get to learn some of the self-management techniques that are taught in the session. Now, through the Division on Aging at the Department of Human Services, we were fortunate to receive a 3-year grant from the Administration on Aging to really expand the availability of this program and promote it across the state. So the online version of the program currently is hosted by the National Council on Aging through a contractual relationship with Stanford. And the slots for the online version of the program we have purchased specifically for the Medicaid managed care members. So that in the course of considering this program as an option for your members, you can either think about the community-based programs, if that would be appropriate, or for a member who may have difficulty getting out to a community-based session or might be restricted by the time that the workshop is offered, then the online version might be a better option. Now, both the online and the community-based programs both offer a companion book. If folks attend the community-based session, it is given to them. If they opt for the online version, it's mailed to them. And the companion book gives them supplemental information to what is actually presented in the workshop. Covers several chronic health conditions, gives additional explanation of relaxation techniques, gives some examples for exercises. So it's a great companion piece that most people really enjoy keeping and using as a resource after the workshop. Now the final thing is it's a lot of discussion occurs throughout the course of the workshop, and as the participants become more comfortable with one another and get to know one another, what they start to do is share more and more information. And it is required that anybody that attends these sessions keep confidentiality so that any information that is shared within the workshop stays within the workshop. That confidentiality is maintained through the online program as well, because the participants create a screen name, so it doesn't have to be their real name, and they communicate with each other through an internal messaging system called a post office or through a discussion center. So they can stay very anonymous in the online program if that's their preference. So the self-management toolbox is a very critical aspect of the program, and this is used in both the community-based and the online program. And under each of these headings, there are various things or activities that the participants are taught to use as tools to help them, again, navigate the issues around chronic health conditions. So for physical activity, people are taught, for example, maybe how to consider starting an exercise program, understanding different types of exercise, how to measure their own fitness and endurance, and how to incorporate those things into their everyday lives. Decision-making, for example, participants are taught a decision-making technique where they can actually write out and through a numerical process try to help weigh out decisions that might be impacting them, their lives, related to their condition or related to something else in their lives. Using your mind is a cognitive techniques that are taught in the program so that individuals can help themselves by using distraction techniques for more minor symptoms like fatigue, pain, to try to get through some daily activities. So there's a host of different activities that come out through the use of the self-management toolbox. And this is referred to over and over again throughout the workshop. And they are displayed for the participants so that they can always be referring to this and know which aspect of the self-management tools they're learning about. Now the image on the slide here, which is Living a Healthy Life with Chronic Conditions, is the book that I had previously mentioned. So this is the book that if participants come to the workshop, they're able to get this book actually in hand, or if they choose the online version, it is mailed to them. And again, just some examples of some of the topics that are covered. Fitness and exercise, I mentioned earlier. Eating well, there is a lot of information, not only in the book, but presented in the workshop about nutrition and maintaining a healthy weight. Medications, which is a struggle for so many people, whether it's medication management or just understanding how to take their medications. Stress management, talking with your doctor, and dealing with emotions and depression. Again, just a few of the topics that are covered throughout the course of the 6 weeks. Now, the benefits of the program. The benefits of the program really have been documented through the research that Stanford has done around the program. They did an initial research study in the early 1990s when the program was first created, and there have been many research studies done since then. And through the research that's been done, and really through the feedback from participants, this is really what is heard over and over again from the individuals that come to these workshops. They generally just feel better. They have learned some ways to help them cope with their chronic health condition that is going to be making their life a little easier, improving the quality of their life. They've met people who are sharing some similar concerns. Very often they've made new friends. It's reduced some social isolation. So generally feeling better is something that is reported frequently. Controlling pain and fatigue. Pain and fatigue are two of the areas that people really struggle with when they have chronic health conditions. And learning some of those techniques to help them manage this on a day-to-day basis is very helpful. Sharing what they know. Very often we hear from participants that their ability to help someone else was a part of what actually helped them through the workshop. They're able to share their own knowledge. If they've been diagnosed with an illness and they've had it for a very long time and someone else in the group has the same illness but they've had it for a shorter period of time, they can actually share their experiences and what's worked for them and not worked for them. And very often that's not something you get from the healthcare provider. You really get that more from a peer, an individual who's sharing the same circumstance as you. And then finding new ways to address their health conditions. If they feel like the only thing I can do for this is take medication, and they learn through the course of the workshop there are other things that they can do to help themselves, it really benefits them overall. So the developers of the program are very fond of saying that the process is more important than the content. And the process is what evolves over the course of the 6 weeks as the workshop is occurring. And again, these same elements apply to both the in-person workshop or the community-based online version. Goal setting, which in this program is called action planning, is a very critical element of the program. What we strive for is individuals to learn how to set goals and achieve small, manageable goals and be successful. We want to build their self-confidence, we want to increase their self-efficacy. We want them to feel like if they can manage or tackle, look at a bigger problem they have, break it down into something smaller, achieve some goals related to that, and then build on that. Build their self-confidence, build that skill of setting a goal and achieving the goal. It helps them not only with managing their chronic health condition, but it's actually a life skill. It can apply to anything. Feedback and sharing, as I had mentioned earlier, really the group members really are very successful with talking with each other, sharing, getting information. That also speaks to brainstorming and problem solving, which are the next two bullet points. These are also techniques that are used repeatedly throughout the program. Brainstorming, where a question is posed to the group and individuals are able to share their ideas. Problem solving occurs when individuals might have challenges around making their goals or achieving their goals. They can come up with suggestions to help each other. Modeling is really what the leaders do to be able to show the individuals what the success could look like. Again, this is ideally why at least one of the leaders is somebody who has a chronic health condition, who's actually using some of the tools in the workshop and applying it to their own life so that they can say to the participants, I've been successful with this, I've tried this tool, it works for me. There might be another one that works better for you. But people do better when they're taught by someone who they see as similar to themselves. An ongoing assessment and reinterpretation of symptoms is really about helping people understand that there might be other causes for symptoms, and if there are other causes, then maybe there are other things that they can do. And they don't feel as maybe depressed or locked in to a defeating situation. So as I had mentioned before, there are two different versions of this program available to the Medicaid managed care members. Take Control of Your Health, which are the community workshops, and Better Choices, Better Health, which is the online version. Now, just to reinforce this point, Better Choices, Better Health, the online version, is available only to the Medicaid managed care members. It is not available to the public at large. With the grant that I mentioned earlier, we have purchased slots so that the Medicaid managed care members can choose this option at no cost. There's also no cost for the community workshops as well. The community workshops are offered throughout the state by various providers that have partnered with us. And I would say that the majority of the workshops that are made available do occur during the week and during daytime hours, which is why we really wanted to include the online version as an option for the Medicaid managed care members so that they can choose to participate in the workshop at their convenience at a time that works best for them. So again, the workshops are available throughout the state. And on your handout, we have a reference to our website where you can search by county. And then in each county, you can look up the providers that are having the workshops. And we ask individuals to contact the workshop directly to see when that provider might have the next available workshop scheduled. In New Jersey, and we're really happy to say that we've had this program since 2006. It's been very successful. We've had over 5,000 participants. We have had a very strong and successful partnership with the Office of Minority and Multicultural Health through the State Department of Health. And through their partnership, we have been able to reach populations that we might not otherwise have reached through our traditional provider network. And more than 50% of the participants over the years have come from minority populations. We've also expanded the different languages that it's offered. Currently in New Jersey, it's offered in English and Spanish, and in some limited geographic areas, it's also offered in Chinese and Korean. And throughout the years, we've had other providers offer it in different languages. As I mentioned earlier, this is an international program, and Stanford actually has the program translated into probably about 20 different languages. So it's really available all over. So a little bit more specifically about the online version of the program, Better Choices, Better Health, you can see the link to the website right there, and there's a screenshot for you of the landing page. And when individuals go in, they do need to sign up, including the information that's on the fields. And again, that's all kept in confidentiality. The other participants within the workshop do not get that information. It goes back to the National Council on Aging so that they can then enroll them in the workshop. What happens is participants do log in up to 3 times a week for 6 weeks on their own schedule. So the time commitment for the online program is identical to the time commitment for the in-person workshop. Again, it's not live. They don't have to log in at a certain time. It's whenever it's convenient for them. One of the fields that you can't see on that image down a little further is a drop-down where it asks them to select their Medicaid managed care plan. And they must fill in that field because, again, this option is only available for the managed care members at this time. All of the other different elements of the program that I discussed earlier, the feedback, problem solving, sharing, they all occur within the online version of the program. Again, it's just done through those message boards and through the post office. They still make action plans. They still learn all the techniques. And these slots are currently available through August of 2014 and most likely will be extended beyond that. But we really do feel, again, that this is a very good option for individuals, particularly those that can't get out to the community-based workshops. So this is an example of one of the activities. What we'd really like to do to help you better understand, because we've been talking about a lot of self-management techniques and tools and things that are involved in the workshop, but just to give you an example of one of the activities that occurs during the workshop to help people learn about cognitive or thinking distraction techniques to help them refocus their mind so they're not maybe thinking about pain or discomfort or shortness of breath. This is a short-term technique that people are taught to use to help them get through activities that might be uncomfortable for them. And that's a distraction technique. And we do have a sample of that that we'd like to take you through right now so that you can have an experience of what the participants learn in the workshop. So what I'd like to do now is read right from a script, just as a leader would during a class, to share with you this one activity, this distraction technique, so that, again, you can experience this and have a better understanding. So I would like you to sit comfortably, relax, close your eyes, and imagine that you're holding a big, bright slice of lemon. Picture it in your mind. You can feel the texture of the lemon rind in your hand. Now lift the lemon to your nose. You can smell its strong citrus aroma. Next, bring the lemon slice to your mouth and take a big bite out of the lemon. It's juicy. The juice squirts all through your mouth. You can taste the tart lemon juice filling your mouth. The juice dribbles down your chin. Suck the juice from that lemon. Now I'd ask you to open your eyes and think about what happened to your body while you were imagining the lemon juice in your mouth. You may have experienced some puckering or salivation or a feeling of tartness that was really created by your mind because there was no lemon there. So just imagine if a technique like that could be used for someone who's experiencing some pain or stress or anxiety. Because if you can totally focus your mind on something like that, then those other things fall away for a short period of time. And that's one of the distraction techniques that's taught in the workshop. We do caution individuals that they are not to use a distraction technique if they're experiencing chest pain, shortness of breath, that these are for short-term activities or for short-term issues that they might be experiencing. So we always felt that reaching out to care managers, nurses, social workers, anybody in the healthcare profession that really touches patients or clients or consumers, that it was always a good audience for us to try to provide information about this program, help you understand what it could do to benefit the individuals that you might contact, because as a care manager, as a nurse, typically you are talking one-on-one to someone, you're starting to understand their health history, their issues, their needs, their family dynamics, and they are going to most likely open up to you more and more about some of the issues that they have around chronic health conditions or ongoing health conditions and really what they might be interested in doing to improve the quality of their life. So here's an opportunity for a care manager to provide another tool, another option to give your client, your patient, some other type of support that is outside of the normal referrals that you might be making. So you really can influence people and encourage them strongly to participate or sign up for this type of program when they might not normally otherwise find it. They might struggle either to find this type of program in the community, might not be aware of it, might think about it and then not really want to go ahead and sign up. It's a 6-week long program that could seem like a long, overwhelming commitment for people. But if they have the support of someone like a care manager who they've developed a relationship with, then perhaps they're going to be more likely to participate in this. And then the outcome on the other end of that is tremendous because you have somebody who is educated, activated, informed, and better able to manage their health condition. So for the purposes of the care manager, it really does extend their reach into the community. As I said, it provides another option to help support the individuals that you're working with. And it enhances the self-management following clinical care. Because very often, patient instruction, patient teaching is provided, but then for an ongoing day-to-day basis to manage conditions, a program like this can be very beneficial. And again, patient education is very different from this program. These are peer-led workshops. Even if the facilitator is a trained healthcare professional, they are acting in a peer capacity. The entire program is scripted. The health messages that are delivered are general health messages. They don't respond to individual questions. If somebody within the group setting asks a very specific question, they don't respond to that within the workshop. They always refer people to go back to their healthcare provider for questions particularly specific to their issue. But patient education is something that the care managers will do, and this is a nice complement. And that's really how this program was designed. It was really designed to help individuals take the knowledge that they're being given about their disease and how to manage it and kind of apply it on a day-to-day basis so that they really can, again, have a better quality of life, and that's the focus. So who should attend this workshop? Well, as I said, this is for individuals with chronic health conditions. They must be at least 18 years of age or over, or if they are a caregiver of someone with a chronic health condition. It is not a disease-specific program. So if somebody has congestive heart failure, heart disease, diabetes, arthritis, those are up there as examples because those are some of the most commonly reported health conditions that we see in the workshop. But we have individuals who have mental health issues that come to the workshop. Also individuals who are survivors of stroke and cancer. So it's whatever they define as their ongoing health condition that they have to cope with on a day-to-day basis. They're welcomed into the session. Because again, as I said earlier, the focus isn't on the disease. The focus is on how do I better manage the symptoms so that my quality of life improves on a daily basis. Pretty much the only exception for individuals that you might not want to refer are those with any type of memory impairment. So somebody who has any type of cognitive impairment, dementia, Alzheimer's disease, you might not want to refer them only because there is some incremental learning that occurs over the course of the workshops. People make action plans that was mentioned earlier, and then the following week they report on those action plans and then they make another one. Somebody who has a memory impairment might not be able to fully participate in that process, and in fact they could be challenging within the group setting. So this really is not appropriate for them. However, a caregiver of someone with a cognitive impairment is very appropriate. So if the caregiver of somebody with Alzheimer's or dementia is interested, this program can really greatly benefit them. So you can see on the slide some triggers for referral, because obviously not everybody is going to be comfortable in a group setting coming to these classes, or as we refer to them, workshops, and sharing some more personal information about themselves. So to determine which individuals might be most open to this type of experience is what the bullet points are listing there. Somebody who really is struggling with the issues around their disease, they're reporting that maybe their social and physical activities have declined. If they're saying, I really want to try to take better control of this issue, they seem to be open to learning new ideas, wanting to speak with someone, or maybe they're the type of person who's already tried other things. They've attended educational programs or support groups. That would really be a good candidate to refer to the program. Now again, keeping this in mind, if you have somebody who is interested in this type of program or you feel might benefit, but is just somebody who you're feeling is not going to be comfortable in the group setting, then the online version is an excellent option because they get all the benefits of the program, they can have that total anonymity, and they can also, again, do it at their own convenience. So as I mentioned, in order to access the workshops, we have either our website, which you have the link for, so that you can search for providers by county, and that's for the community-based workshops, or the online version. You also have that link if members want to go online. But for every managed care organization, the process of getting that member to the workshop or to the online program may be different. So that would be for your organization to determine how the care manager would actually handle that referral. Would they actually assist the individual in seeking out and signing up for the program, or would they simply provide them with information about it? That varies from organization to organization, and that's what your agency would handle at this point. So from the information that I've shared about the program, you can see that this isn't really a traditional health education program. It's not a support group. It's a very encompassing workshop. And to try to explain it to people with a lot of detail can be challenging. So what we often encourage people to do is really tell them a little bit about the program, but then focus on the positive outcomes of the program. Use positive messages. And here are some examples that you see on the screen to help people be encouraged to sign up for these programs. We are sharing more of the nuts and bolts, if you will, the guts of the program with you so that you have an understanding of it to better refer people. But when you're actually referring individuals to the program, it's generally better just to use positive messages and then encourage them to sign up. Or again, if your protocol is that you're going to assist them with signing up, then you can take that next step. So every workshop concludes with an evaluation, a very brief evaluation that the participants are asked to complete, and they are given an opportunity to share some of their thoughts about the program. And these are actual quotes from participants that have come from those evaluation forms. And you can see, you know, now I have the energy to do the things that matter. I'm more confident about my health, and I got relief from my pain. You know, speaks volumes. Or I've learned we're all in the same boat, but the boat is not sinking. And again, that's what comes out of the sharing of the group members. This slide gives you a summary of the research. You can find more detail about this on Stanford's website. But again, one of the reasons that we have promoted and espoused this program, and at the national level that's happening as well, is because of the proven benefits of the program, because it does reduce cost. Because 6 months, 1 year, even 2 years later, we're still seeing benefits through, again, the initial research study that was done by Stanford, and then other studies that have been done subsequent to that one. And reducing healthcare cost, of course, is a huge initiative that we're proud to be participating in by making this program available throughout the state. Just to refer back to, again, the websites that I had mentioned throughout the discussion, Better Choices, Better Health, the online version of the program, the link there will get you directly to the landing page, which was the image on the previous screen where people can sign up. And one note about Better Choices, Better Health. The structure of that program is that it brings together people from all over the country. Again, it's completely anonymous. But those workshops are held with 25 participants. So when 25 people have signed up from all over the country, they initiate a new workshop. That's different from the community-based program where I had mentioned that the groups are small. They're 10 to 16 people held locally. But in the Better Choices, Better Health workshop, they do expand it to 25 people, and it is, as I said, from all over the country. Take Control of Your Health, the link to our website, so that you can search for a provider in your county or maybe a nearby county and see when they have workshops available. And we have supported a lot of these providers through grant funding to make the workshops available and encourage them to welcome all members of the community so that your managed care members can certainly access any of the workshops that they find through our providers. And then the link to Stanford University to learn more about the program. There is a handout in your materials which gives you more information about the program and repeats Stanford's website so that you can learn more about the research. So the contact information for the individuals at the Department of Human Services, Dennis McGowan is the acting program manager for our wellness unit, and myself, Andrea, and my contact information is there, because if you have questions and you're interested in referring someone, or you just generally have questions about the program, please feel free to contact us, because we're always happy to talk to individuals and help them learn more about the program. Throughout the course of this presentation, I mentioned a few handouts that are available for your use. We have a one-page sheet with information about both the community-based program and the online program. We also have the triggers for referral, which was mentioned in the previous slide. And then the script that I had read with the lemon activity is available for your use and review. And there's also a second script for a more detailed distraction activity that you may want to use or practice if you're going to use this presentation to educate others about the program. All of those handouts are available on the website that you see on the screen so that you can access them for future use. And we'd like to conclude the presentation by sharing with you a brief video that was created by the National Council on Aging about 2 to 3 years ago. This video was created to promote a few different evidence-based programs that are available, but the main focus of the video is on chronic disease self-management. Many of the individuals filmed in the video actually are from New Jersey, and it is a nice way for you to see individuals who have actually participated in the workshop giving some testimonial and sharing their experience and their benefits. So we would like to conclude with having you watch that video now.
Health for a Lifetime, brought to you by the National Council on Aging.
Well, I have emphysema, and I also have osteoporosis.
I have kidney disease, arthritis.
I need help.
I can't do it by myself.
High blood pressure, heart disease, diabetes. Today, 4 out of 5 older adults are living with long-term health problems. As many as half are juggling 3, 4, even 5 conditions at the same time. The high cost of long-term illness consumes a staggering 95% of all senior healthcare spending. And too many older adults find that their health problems interfere with the relationships and activities they love the most.
In my church, I'm a greeter and usher, and I'm a prayer warrior. I must stand. Well, I'll tell you, it was the hardest for me to do that. And I began to dread Sundays.
For people with long-term health conditions, 95% of their care is actually self-care. And patients and physicians agree that the traditional office visit can't provide all the support they need.
The real challenge is getting people to change their behaviors. And changing behaviors does not happen in a 20-minute, 15-minute office visit. It takes a lot of effort, a lot of repetition, and a lot of support. It actually takes a village.
The solution? Community-based workshops called Chronic Disease Self-Management Programs. Participants get encouragement from each other and practical advice on living better with their conditions.
I wanted to know, how do you manage this? How do you manage blood pressure? What are the things I should not eat, and what are the things I should eat?
These workshops and others, like Matter of Balance, Healthy Ideas, and Enhanced Fitness, are credible research-backed programs that help older adults put life back in their lives.
People with chronic illness live more than 99% of their time outside of the healthcare system. And what we're trying to help them do is live that 99% of the time. We're not doing diagnosis, we're not doing treatment. We're helping them get on with their lives in the face of chronic illness.
Workshops meet once a week for 6 weeks. The meetings are interactive, include people with many different conditions, and are run by trained peer leaders or coaches.
I think it is very good to use lay leaders because many of them have chronic diseases themselves and can relate to the same things that the people in the class are talking about.
So what we try to do is get people to set weekly goals of something they would like to do, and that they really think they can do. So it may be walking a little bit. It may be writing a letter to a friend. It may be eating one more apple a day. Little things.
We set our goals and then we tried to do it, and I increased my exercises from 5 minutes a day, and I got up to 15 minutes a day, and I felt I was doing well.
Here, older adults build their coping skills by creating realistic weekly action plans for diet and exercise.
And walking them all, right? Walking them all.
Building self-confidence.
Good. I'm glad that you did do it.
Learning self-care and communication skills, and finding a supportive community.
And this way, I knew the people and felt they were my friends, and I could discuss it more openly.
It was the help of others that made me say, I can do this.
One of the surprises was how much we have grown to learn and love the program. Everyone who participates on a class leader level always ends up coming back talking about the sheer joy, and it's that, you know, happy people feeling.
Chronic disease self-management programs deliver real-life results for older adults and a tested cost-effective option for healthcare providers.
We see these improved results at 6 months, at 1 year, and at 2 years, still making a difference in people's lives. It's also appears to lead to reduced use of the emergency room, in some cases, reduced use of inpatient stays.
I think the most important part was that the participant came into realization that they have the responsibility to take care of their own health. And there's not only the doctor or somebody else that have to take care of their health.
I've changed quite a bit from how I behaved before. And after the class, I'm able to manage my disease.
By the end of the program, I would run in here, and I said, I can do it. Let me tell you what happened to me. I said, I'm standing, I'm walking, I'm enjoying it. And I said, people are noticing the change in me.
Welcome to Central Baptist.
And honestly, people began to notice. They go, Bernice, you're still standing.
I have more energy. There's no doubt about it. I have more energy. I feel as though I'm standing straighter. I feel as though my posture's better. I just feel good.
Health for a Lifetime, brought to you by the National Council on Aging. Support for this video was generously provided through grants from the Atlantic Philanthropies and the Administration on Aging.